Hello, I am Elgun Mammadov with the latest news in English on AzVision TV. President of Azerbaijan Ilham Aliyev has received credentials of the newly appointed Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of Ecuador, German Alejandro Ortega Almeida. President Ilham Aliyev has also accepted credentials of the newly appointed Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of Chile, José Manuel Silva. Over the past 24 hours, Armenian armed forces have violated the ceasefire along the contact line between Azerbaijani and Armenian troops 116 times, the Azerbaijani Defense Ministry reported. The investigation into crimes committed by Armenians against Azerbaijanis is continuing, said Azerbaijan's military prosecutor Khanlar Valiyev while addressing a board meeting at the military prosecutor's office.
We have made much progress on an investigation launched over the Khojaly, Karadaghlı, Meshaly, Baganesarim tragedies as well as other crimes and terrorist acts committed by the Armenians. Investigative and operational measures on the relevant criminal cases are underway.
The Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan expressed gratitude to the Azerbaijani delegation to PACE for supporting the Operation Olive Branch at the winter session of the organization.
I express my gratitude to Azerbaijani MP Samet Seydo for supporting the Operation Olive Branch which Turkey conducts against terrorists.
PACE unanimously adopted a report on strengthening international regulations against trade in goods used for torture and the death penalty by Azerbaijani Member of Parliament Vusal Hüseynov at the winter session today. The PACE also listened to a report on children suffering from armed conflicts. As the report was discussed by the session participants, Azerbaijani MP Vusal Hüseynov reminded that the assembly should not obviate from anything and call child murders by their name.
I think, dear colleagues, we should be very frank and we should speak based on our resolutions, based on our documents we adopted. If we yesterday gave a warm welcome to Mr. Sarkisian, to the president of Armenia, who publicly acknowledged and stated that he took part in killing of civilians in Khojaly town, which was the occupied territory of Azerbaijan, and which is increasingly recognized as a genocide by foreign legislative bodies, by international organizations. And the day after we discuss here how we can improve the situation of children in the conflict, of course we cannot be very effective, and by that, of course, we start losing our face. And there is ongoing talk that we are losing the trust of the people, we are losing the objectivity. So I think that's one of the reasons. So we should name the criminal by his name, and regardless of the post he is holding. So therefore, I call on you to pay attention to this while voting to the report.
The Russian co-chair of the OSCE Minsk group, Igor Popov, has revealed the details of Krakow meeting of the Armenian and Azerbaijan's ministers. He also noted that the OSCE Minsk group co-chairs will visit the region in early February. The co-chairs will also meet with Azerbaijani and Armenian presidents during their visit to the region. The sides will discuss the ways of resolving the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict.
Igor Popov, the Russian co-chair of the OSCE Minsk group, says the meeting between the ministers of foreign affairs of Azerbaijan and Armenia focused on reducing military risks, including expanding the OSCE monitoring mission in the conflict zone. The ministers gave their principal consent to the documents defining the activities of additional 7 observers prepared by the mediators. Prior to the launch of such a mechanism for expanding the monitoring mission, there are still some technical details that must be agreed, Popov added. The ideas voiced by the co-chairs aim to find a solution acceptable for both parties.
We hope to clarify Azerbaijan's and Armenian's position within the framework of our meetings within the presidents during our visit to the region, scheduled to take place in the first 10 days of February.
The Russian co-chairman said that as mediators, they favor continuing the political dialogue on a supreme level, to which there is no alternative.
For the next high-level summit to happen, there needs to be careful preparations aimed at agreeing on what has to be the main subject of the meeting. We ourselves endeavor to give useful options to Baku and Yerevan.
The co-chairs are going to discuss this during their next visit to the region. Popov said available options, including the date and format for the summit, can be offered when the sides are ready to meet and considering the two presidents' work schedule.
Swedish member of the European Parliament and Foreign Relations Committee Lars Adaktusson has made an illegal visit to the Armenian-occupied Nagorno-Karabakh region. He met with the foreign minister of the so-called Nagorno-Karabakh Republic, Mas Ismailian. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Azerbaijan would like to remind all nationals of the foreign countries that anyone who visits Nagorno-Karabakh and the other occupied regions of Azerbaijan without permission and consent conducts an illegal act. Such visits violate the territorial integrity of Azerbaijan, and our government can take appropriate legal actions with regard to the visitors of above-mentioned territories. Georgi Tsvetili, the president of the OSCE Parliamentary Assembly, will visit Azerbaijan in 2018. He announced his decision on visiting Azerbaijan while addressing the OSCE Permanent Council in Vienna. His visit will focus on Armenia-Azerbaijan Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. International Secretariat of Parliamentary Assembly will accompany the president during his stay in the country. A group of 43 Azerbaijani soldiers serving within the NATO-led Resolute Support Mission in Afghanistan have returned to Baku on a rotating basis, the Defense Ministry reported today. That was all for today from AzVision TV. Thank you for watching. Have a great weekend.